This is Mission Control Houston. Expedition 28 on the International Space Station devoted most of the day on Thursday to supplies issues as well as science work while the ground teams assess the impact from Wednesday's loss of a Progress ship. Progress number 44 suffered a failure of 5 minutes and 20 seconds into its flight yesterday. The third stage booster failed and left the vehicle without enough energy to reach orbit. It impacted the ground in the southern Siberia. There are enough supplies on board for the crew to last into March. In the meantime, a Russian commission is studying yesterday's event to determine what occurred, and teams in Houston and at the other control centers are assessing possible impacts to station supply schedules as well as crew rotation schedules. Today, Commander Andrei Borisenko and his Russian crewmates, Alexander Samokutdiaev and Sergei Volkov, conducted a Russian PAO event in the morning and spent most of their afternoon working on a Russian video production about life on orbit. Borisenko also spent time today unpacking the Progress ship that is still docked to the International Space Station. Flight engineer Mike Fossum ended up spending most of his day doing maintenance work on the carbon dioxide removal assembly, which is located in the floor of the Destiny Laboratory. The Sidra does just what his name implies. He was working to bypass a faulty sensor. He later in the day, Fossum also joined flight engineers Satoshi Furukawa and Ron Garin for interviews with KGO Television and Space.com. Early in his day, Ron Garin worked on the VO2 Max experiment, in which he exercises on the Cevis treadmill while instrumented to measure his physical responses. The experiment is gathering data on the efficiency of oxygen intake by people who are on a long-duration spaceflight. Garin also spent part of his day doing maintenance on the waste hygiene compartment. Satoshi Furukawa also doing some maintenance work today on the water quality monitoring kit. He also joined Garin for some work packing items inside the pressurized mating adapter number 2. The Expedition 28 crew is ready to pick up its work later this week and into next week as it is directed by its mission control centers on the ground once the impacts of the Progress launch are assessed and a new plan is formulated.